So, hello everyone. Today we will continue with our remaining topics of the lesson 4. So, the first topic is library, function library. Okay, the first topic is function library. So, what is it? The function library contains all the formulas that are available within the Excel. Okay, मतलब means all types of formulas contained in a function library. That is why it is called a library of function. Okay, there are lots of formula like sum, average count, minimum, maximum, LCM, G, CD, etc. So the first one is LCM function. LCM function, what function does perform by the LCM? So it returns the least common multiple of integers. Okay, LCM you have already learned about the LCM in mathematics. So the same function works on Excel also, na? So that's example LCM of 24, 56, and 18 is if we apply the LCM function, then it will return the 504. Okay, the result will 504. So how to use LCM function in Excel? The steps are select the cell like B5. It's an example that you have to select the B5 cell. Then click on the formula tab. Then after that, click on maths and trig formula. Okay, maths and trig. Trig means trigonometrical formula option. Then click on LCM function, and the second last step says to type the arrangements in number fields B2, B3, or B4, as we have already selected B5, so that is why we select these fields cells in the number 1, number 2, and number 3 text boxes. Means when you click on the LCM function option, then a dialog box is appear asking for your arguments. So just put up these type of arguments and then click on the OK button. Okay, so this is how we can apply LCM function in our Excel data, and like that we can also perform GCD function. Okay, GCD function return the greatest among other divisor of two or more integers, and AutoSum function add all the values. I have already explained AutoSum function, sum and average also explained by me at your practical videos. Okay, so the process of applying GCD and other functions are same. So we just move to our next topic, which is conditional formatting. What is it? Conditional formatting allow you to automatically apply formatting such as color, icons, etc. bar means it allow us to automatically apply formatting such as color, icon, etc. on one or more cell, either one or more than one cell or cells or range of the cells depending on the certain condition. You can apply all the cells or either one or range of the cells depending on the certain condition specified by you. So how to apply? Steps are as follows. Select the cell range on a worksheet. You just need to select the cell range and click on the conditional formatting in styles group on home tab. When you click on home tab, then as style group, you can find conditional formatting option. Okay, then click on the option as per your requirements. Type the values of format depending on the certain conditions. Select the formatting style that you want to apply, like light red color or something else. Formatting means arrange karna, or you can say the decorate karna, okay, to decorate our Excel sheet. Then last one is click on the OK button. By this, you can apply conditional formatting on your Excel sheet. Okay, now the next topic is data sorting. Data sorting. What is data sorting? Sorting data rearrange the data in a particular order, either in ascending or descending order. Sorting means rearrange the data in a particular order, either in ascending or descending order, depending on your condition. Okay, so if you have a data like students' marks on a particular subject, then you can arrange them in ascending or descending order. If you have a name of the students in a variety of form, like Z letter firstly appeared and A letter lastly appeared, so you can arrange systematically A to Z or Z to A as per your requirement with the help of sorting. Okay, so how to apply? Select the cell with the data to sort. Steps are select the cells. Okay, then click on the data tab. Okay, then click on the sort option from sort and filters option. Then a dialog box will appear on the screen and select any options that you want to apply, like total marks or something else as per your need, and click on the OK button. Okay, so this is how you can apply sorting. I have already explained sorting and filter options to your practicals videos, previous practical videos. Okay, so just look at them. You can watch that video also for more understanding. Filtering, it is a quick way to display only those records that meet the specified criteria and hides all the rest of the record. Means it is showing only that particular record which specified the certain criteria, and then hide all the remaining records. So it is filter. Steps are same as the sorting, but you have to select filter option instead of sorting option. Okay, that is how you can apply sorting and filter. One more topic is there, which is theoretical portion, like advanced filter option. So just understand, advanced filter is used to create a list of unique items to extract specific item to a different worksheet. Okay, you can also use complex criteria with each advanced filter. So that is how advanced filters works. The steps are as follows. Just like you apply the sorting and filter, steps are as follows. Just you need to select the advanced filter option instead of these two options. Okay, so by this your fourth lesson has been ended today. Functions in MS Excel has been ended today. The practical portion of this lesson will covered in the practical videos. So I hope you enjoy the video. And thank you, everyone.